Well, the lanterns for us are a symbol of joy and welcome. There's a whole range of different lanterns. So a lot of them are Australian symbols, koalas, kangaroos, but also symbols from refugee cultures. So there's African drums, African mama. They're a symbol of the bringing of different cultures together. The event's been running here in Brisbane for 5 years. We started as a very small event with 50 people, and last year we had 4,000 people come and walk with us.
I've been making lanterns for around about 25 years. I've been involved with the Refugee Day Candlelight Walk since the second year that it's been in existence, and I think that's about 4 years. They're made with a variety of materials. We use cane and bamboo for the most part, and we cover them with silk, and we also cover them with a laminate of kitchen wrap, just plain old sandwich wrap, and glue. And then we paint them, of course. The lanterns are a really beautiful metaphor for the light shining within, which is a symbol of hope and a brighter future. For many people in from different countries, lanterns have the same significance, so it's something that they can relate to, and they innately understand the metaphors that we use here.
I think events like this are critical for the refugee community in Australia. That sense of welcome and inclusiveness is really important for refugees, particularly when there's a lot of public debate about whether refugees and asylum seekers are welcome. The message that I would give current refugees is that our experience of the Australian population is that Australians live the values of compassion. We're very committed to a fair go, and that generally you're very welcome here in the Australian community, and that people value the contribution that waves and waves of refugees since the Second World War have made to this community.